Greetings and salutations. Welcome back to Builders 2. We're making Midenhall. Still. So let's hop on in. Hey. Haven't even gotten anywhere yet. This must be a real awkward angle. Okay, so we are doing this. This must be a real awkward angle because she keeps like pointing her face down when it is distinctly not down. Okay, so first thing we're doing today, making a church. Then we're gonna go from there. How do we make a church? I have no idea. So we're gonna go back to the actual Midenhall and figure that one out. Are those, like, all sea anemones? Or whatever they're called? Let's see if that helps at all. Nah, it's still a weird angle because now she's always got her head pointed. We'll figure something out. Oh, that's friggin' pretty. How did they do that? Okay, making a church. Oh, I forgot this whole place over here just kind of didn't exist. Okay. Be the easiest way to do this. Probably start like out here. How do you play this game?
Trivia.
Thanks for the resub, Dresden. So that's that button. Now what button am I looking for? That one. Then that button. Okay. Now we can actually make us a blueprint. Heck. This place is difficult to get to. This should be good enough. This should get us everything. No, it needs to be one out, actually. What do you mean I can't put it there? I put it where I want. Okay, well, we should probably have the whole height. Yeah, this shouldn't be too bad. This shouldn't be too bad. Doesn't really matter. Sure. Okay, we did it. We got us a blueprint. Now let's get out of here. This should not be that hard to make. Hello. I mean, that looks crazy. I'm sure it's just a trick of putting the right camera angle in the right place and using some of the pre-existing, like spouts and stuff, but that looked kind of crazy. What color is Zara's hair? It looks like it's a dirty blonde. I was confused because in the lighting, I thought, like, is her hair just blonde? I don't remember her just being blonde. But you catch it in the right light and you see, like, it's not blonde blonde. It almost looks like it has a little green to it. Okay, so I'm back. I got blocks. We got you up here in case I need to build things. Got you down there. What kind of blocks do I need for this? I've got a bunch of blocks. I'm gonna need more than 118 checkerboard though. That may be enough to get us going, at least. Okay. So we need, it looks like one below the ceiling. Okay, so that's that layer. That's the layer below it. And that is indeed open. So this is the layer that I need. Right here. So what is it exactly? Looks like just a layer of checkerboard the whole way. Windows go up a notch. Pillars go up a notch. Like the, it doesn't do anything fancy, just the entire previous floor gets. Or no, this is actually the layer that I need right here. Which still just looks like a layer of checkerboard. Layer of checkerboard, and we fill in behind the pillars up front. Okay, I'm gonna need pillars. So you're going to have to come up. There we go, nice and easy. You're gonna have to come up. And you're gonna have to come up. At least I don't think that hacked anything up. Okay, I think that's it for that layer. We just need to bring the pillars up. And to do that, I need more pillars. Ah, it is enough to get to the stairs. Okay, what's a pillar under? Ten should be enough. I only need, like, eight. Okay, since it's connected to a... Since it's connected to the castle and it's not its own building, it's not a church, it's a chapel. Cool, I will forget that. Okay, there we go. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Okay, so that's that level done. We literally just fill everything with checkerboard. I'm gonna need more checkerboard. We'll see how far 236 gets us. Get us farther than I thought it would get us. What's everybody been up to? Getting interested in anything? Watch any good shows? Read any good books? I've actually been reading Baki lately. Like Baki the Grappler. I don't know, he's got like, it's hard to remember which, it's hard to say which one in particular because the whole series is like friggin' eight different series of different names, but it's the whole box. There we go. Oh, Oh, Digimon 2020. I gotta look into that. Okay, so that was that lair. Okay, so it looks like we use flat tops around the entire edge. And then there's kind of a design in the middle. I want to say a flat top goes here too, but I do not remember. Nope, no flat top there. Got the whole two gap. Then that going out. Okay. Oh, the 100% sub 2 hour bunny must die. That sounds miserable. I mean, good luck to you, though. Okay, so I think we have that. So it comes out. So we have a two square, and two. So two square. Okay, two square, two, and then another two centered. And that's our pattern. We have six in the corner there. Yes, we do. The rest is filled with checkerboard. I'm gonna need more checkerboard. Well, that's what I said last time. Let's ride out and see what happens. Yeah, I'm gonna need more checkerboard. I was inside the stairs. It's weird how things work, because you go for a really long break and you'd think, okay, you're gonna get super rusty. But I found, like, some games I've built that in and it just stays there. I haven't played Super Metroid in 2 years. And I feel like I could pick it up and blitz through almost as easily as I used to be able to. I'm sure there's some, like, nuance and some tricks here and there that I'd heck up. I know when I grabbed the randomizer again. The combo randomizer, for example. I couldn't remember my opener. I couldn't remember the... Like, I completely forgot about getting the Houlihan room for money. Like, I feel like my biggest problem is remembering things to do. But I feel like the muscles remember how to do, as long as the brain remembers what to do. Okay, that was that floor. Okay, so we just continue the pattern of the pointy tops, the weird tops, the top blocks, pretty much the whole way down. Checkerboard just outside of them, weird block on top of that. I can make them. Without having to go back up. This is what I did way back during the actual videos. The actual series. I assume these are lined up the same on this side. Yeah, they are. Okay, then we got checkerboard out here. Yeah. and weird blocks. That's not what I wanted. I'm gonna need a lot of weird blocks before I can do much else, I think. Well, I can put that edge up, but I don't even think I have the blocks for that. Well, I can do this. And now I need the corner pieces. Flat tops, the weird blocks, okay, so these, I'm gonna need, I don't know how many of these. Go with 50 for now and see what happens. Then I need these. Otherwise, I have 66, 462. I should at least be in the ballpark of having what I need otherwise. So this is weird block, goes out here. Yeah, okay, so I did that right. Just around that and then one more. These need to go here. And then we got a bunch of flat tops that go in some way that I don't remember at all. Okay, so coming off of the final outcropping, we have a 2 square, then in 2, 1, 2. So 2 square, 2, 1, 2. So that's here. Two, one, two. And I think that does that. Also egg. No, not quite. Those are checkerboards. Why? Why do you gotta be this one? Heck up anything, but it doesn't look like it hecked up anything below that. Yep, we're good otherwise. So, from here, we are... We're building up that tower, and we're building up the staircase. Which seems pretty easy. I need stairs. I got weird blocks, so I can at least put them down. I think that's just stairs left and I'm done. What is that though? Okay, it's actually that piece. So stairs. Stairs and this tower, and we are done. So this is a little funky, because it just does this. Just builds it right on top of itself. I'm assuming it's a gap of two. Two the whole way. And that fills with checkerboard. Okay, then we have tops again. We got you. Okay, that's that. Have a straight up circle of checkerboards. Circle of tops. Perfect. Quit eating my inputs, just let me put it down. And then the top goes on that, so I need the stairs. 2, 4, 6 stairs and the top of that. Stairs are easy. Where is the top of this thing? I mean, there's the green one. That's big. Bam. I better not have to rotate that. I have to rotate that. Okay, I gotta put the spike tops on top of stuff. But otherwise, I think we're done. How many do I need? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, like 12. All right, we did it. Chapel is done. That wasn't so bad. So our next goal is gonna be doing something over there. I knew the chapel wasn't gonna take that long. So I'm feeling like the next thing we'll want to do is make the thing over here. I was debating doing the one over there, but I feel like doing the one over here would be easier. Like, I feel like making this, the top of this, the roof of this hall, outstretching from here is going to be easier than doing it from there. That's what I feel. So time to go make another blueprint. Oh, it's been a while since I can remember the specifics of what happened in Astral Chain. I don't even remember a Nier Automata reference in it, though. Yeah, it's like a little green. Her hair is like a little, it's not blonde. It's like a blonde green. Okay, so we have this wall here. I'll probably just build up to this wall. Pretty obvious staircase there. Whole courtyard deal. Thank you. So we're gonna wanna grab enough of what else we got here to kinda know what's going on. So let's grab like over here. Perfect. Yeah, that'll grab one block extra so we have something to work with. Then we'll go over here and grab up to... Oh, I don't know. I didn't go out far enough. Let's go out to like here. And let's go back up. Because we gotta redraw that. And we'll go to... There we go. Yeah, plenty of space. I know we're not missing anything. I mean, also fantasy hair colors. Because here I am with bright pink hair. This should also be pretty easy. I don't think I'll be able to get yet a third piece. Whoa, thanks, thanks, Griff. You're a pal. Okay, so. My mic here. Real Where does one even begin, really? I mean, I guess we can just build up. It's two layers below the floor. So this layer is the one that I need to know about. It seems to just be checkerboard everywhere. Checkerboard everywhere, which is reasonably simple. If we're going out that far, that means we're going four checkerboard on the left. What am I doing about this? Yeah, it's still open. The only difference is I have a block right there to put down. Yep. Three and then in. Okay, so what exactly... So it looks like four on either side for the most part. That turns into a big, thick son of a gun. It's still just checkerboard the whole way. How far am I going? So it starts there, so I'm gonna wanna go... That'll get me ground down for the edge of that if I go up to... Well, exactly as far as I did go. Get that creamy nougat filling. All right. So this is the next layer I need to do, which is just more checkerboard. There's a flat top in that corner, and that extends out. So, oh, there's also some flat tops over there. You know, they're probably on both sides. So that's flat top, boom, 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 boom. Gets filled in checkerboard. All right, so that's that done. Next floor is... So there's a layer of flat tops right across the center. Otherwise, it's entirely checkerboard. What are you guys talking about? Just less broken. It's the same castle, the same Midenhall that you ran into in the story, only not broken and destroyed. I want to remake it kind of in its ideal shape. This is what it used to look like. Maybe this is going to go quicker than I thought it was going to go, because that's it. We're up to floor level. So that looks like checkerboard. A single line of checkerboard on the entire outside edge. So that there. And then on this side, this one is going to be a little harder for me to parse. So it starts at that edge. So it's going to be like here. And it'll go on this side until here? Because I left space on this side for two blocks. Yeah, that lines up. Okay, that side's easy. We got the weird blocks, two on the edges. We got one more weird block and then a spike top on top of everything. Perfect, but I'm gonna need more for this side anyway. Man, I already need to egg again. Okay, this side is gonna be a little more interesting. Okay, it looks like just yet another row of checkerboards. Maybe a flat top there, otherwise it's just all another row of checkerboard. Where was it? I think it was here.
Let's go, go, go!
Oh, I already need more checkerboards. Would Midenhall Prime be an Autobot or a Decepticon? I say Autobot. I say Autobot. Because unlike a lot of JRPGs, the Dragon Quest series actually has royalty and kings that are generally good and want to get crap done and help people. And Midenhall was no different. What did I come here for? Checkerboards. No, I do not need 5,000. I mean, I probably will. But let's just start with 500. And we'll get there eventually. What would it transform into? A castle, obviously. There have been Autobots that just turn into, like, a base that other bots go into? Or Transformers that just turn into a big base? Okay, so next up looks like a row of laptops. With checkerboards on the outside. I need more flat tops. Like, heck, the Transformers planet is a Transformer. And all it does is be a planet. Okay, so that's that one. Next up, Weird Boys. The entire stretch is Weird Boys. An entire layer of Weird Boys. When I need more Weird Boys to finish up the next layer. Okay, so those are our Weird Boys. So it looks like we have an extra here. And how's this gonna work? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Yeah, that makes sense. That works. That fits. Anything else I'm gonna need? Spike tops. It should not matter that the Weird Boys are rotated. There's nothing I can do to fix that anyway. Like most blocks, you can rotate. But you cannot rotate the Weird Boys. Thank you. they will always be facing a specific direction. And on the map, this entire castle is rotated 90 degrees to the original castle. So all the weird boys are always going to be facing the wrong direction. I think I did it. And I think that's our entire wall. Well, how about that? It's still early. We did the top of the chapel and this bridge. And we got plenty of time still. Oh, do I want to try to do this wall? I feel like it would be more important to try to do this. So do I want to try to heck with this room? I feel like this hall is actually going to be a pain in the butt. And it'll probably be easier to make this over here anyway. Well, maybe that'll work out well. That means we can do this tonight, and then next week we can do this, and then set up a whole new wood ocean. Yeah, that's what I'm feeling. Getting there. I feel like this tower will be easier to do than that wall. Bye. getting late, and I'm getting home. Yeah, how does this even work? It, like, steps up. This thing is gonna be such a... This hall... This wall over here is going to be such a monumental pain in the butt. I'm just gonna start making crap up, is what I'm gonna do, because it's gonna be rough. Okay, so let's grab one extra. Which will now take us out here. Yeah, one extra all around. Start down there, which that's not actually low enough. I mean, I've got to be careful. Gotta be careful because I don't want it to go too far down. Like, I want it right here, I just want it lower. Sure. Okay, that at least gets me to see that, which is good. I can work with that. But as long as I'm here, go one block all around, and we can go down far enough to see most of that room. Cool. I like it. Orientation, eh? Bingo. Back we go. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get some more nougat. I don't know where it all went. This avatar does not like it when I slouch. Nougat boat. Thanks, Drift. Come on, select it. These somewhere a little bit closer, like right here. Actually, I don't want them right there. I'm gonna be building there. Alright, get our tasty center back. And then let's figure out what we're doing with this. Okay, so this is four layers below the... floor. So this is the last layer that I actually built. So above that is... entirely checkerboard. Just fill it in with checkerboard. Hmm. that's 3 on the right side, 2 on the left. Okay, that should be enough nougat. On this side, we got wrong blueprint. There we go, that does that, and then this side I build just out here. Okay, so flat tops along the bottom, everything else is filled with checkerboard. So that's not there. That easy, then fill the checkerboard. Yep. All right. Hard to tell what exactly is going on. So we have those come in. I think that's only one more than I already have. Hard to say if the other ones actually mean anything. Okay, so there is a 3x3 and then four.
Let's go, go, go!
So we got the four there. And then, I think it's like two over here. I don't know how much I trust that. We'll see what it looks like when we're done. Oh no, that's way in. Yeah, that's only two in from that. Should put it here. No, not there, here. Yeah, again, we'll see what it looks like when we're done. Because I don't know. I think that's it. Everything else is checkerboard. Yep. Checkerboard it is. That's our floor. So what kind of fun do we have from here? Okay, so checkerboard, then a row of straights, and then two up, and a row of straights. Yep. Just fill that in with checkerboard. Actually, no, it's got two, one more on the outside and then checkerboard for the wall. That kind of does the same thing on the other side. Except it goes in two. So that's like there and there. And like that. So I'll have one over here. So it's like that. Yeah, might as well just pull that straight. So that will just be two on the edge. Goes up four, comes in, goes up three. Is this where it goes up three? Like that? Yeah. And then similarly on the other side. Same four, same three. And that should let me put down some corners. Boy for lives. Mostly don't think too hard about it. I'm Naka. How are you? The avatar that you see up is Vivian. She's there because I think she's cute. And also, I have a complicated relationship with gender identity. Okay, so what do we got over here? Checkerboard that just goes back. Checkerboard that goes back on that side. Okay, so I should put these corners in, is what I should do. So we have two in from there. So we do this, and then... Boop, 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 boop. I can grab the bottom if I do that. Can I, like, do that? Yeah! This is awkward as heck to grab these. Okay, so we got that. I don't think I needed this one, actually. I think I just fill with checkerboard. And I think that gets filled with checkerboard, too. Yeah, that's checkerboard too. And even that corner piece is checkerboard. Oh no, there's no turn in that corner. That's just checkerboard going straight back. Now, the reason this one is checkerboard is it hex up the inside, because that should be flat inside, but outside it makes a clean wall. Which is also probably why you are also checkerboard. Yeah. I was wondering what was up with those. So I guess that's it for this layer, mostly. So we can go next layer. Mostly it's just a pure checkerboard version of the previous layer. Except the stair side. It goes two and then has one flat. And we eat some eggs. And willing to bet these are also. Dang it, not there. There. Okay, I think that's all right. Yeah, last time we, and a little bit the time before, but last time we talked about a little bit of lore surrounding Vivian. She is a robot maid. She's doing her best. Her personality is very similar to Splatoon 2's Marina, where she is mature, maybe even a little motherly. A little bit naive about the ways of the world, and a little bit problems. She was programmed primarily to be a maid, so she's not really sure. She doesn't really understand how to do not be a maid, specifically for the person she was assigned to, her current employer. So she would have a very I feel like she would have a very difficult time if she were suddenly dropped into society and say, do your own thing, because she wasn't programmed to not be that person's maid. I feel like she would figure it out, but it would be an awkward time. I say her current employer. I like the word employer as opposed to master. She's not a slave. This isn't some fetish either. So I say employer. Her employer is a reasonably well-off businesswoman who has a broadcasting room set up for, like, meetings and that kind of thing. But when her employer isn't using it, and Vivian doesn't especially have any work to do at the moment, Vivian's employer lets her play video games in it. Does Vivian know how to make weapons? No, not at all. But she can work a dust broom if she has to. Those dust bunnies will never know what hit them. She is not a combatant. At all. Is it just checkerboard that goes out here? Yeah, it's just checkerboard. No need to overthink things. Okay, that was that layer. Next layer is pretty much the same thing, except flat tops. I will say Vivian is probably unusually strong for her frame, given that she is an android, but she does, in fact, have no idea how to fight. Yeah, it's just a flat top version of the previous. I'm gonna need more flat tops. I need to just go make some bottom pieces or something, because this is a pain in the butt. Let's just make some bottom pieces. I need, what, 4? Thank you. Nah. Okay, better than nothing. So that's that layer. Next layer is almost entirely checkerboard. Oh, I didn't put that flat top down there. These one goes there and one goes there. Is there a particular reason those are there? Not at all. Okay, so we got the weird boys going out that way. We have the top piece there. Need the 8 weird boys. And the rest just gets filled in with checkerboard. I will say Vivian straight up has no idea how to fight. Straight up no idea how to fight. If she, even against a random mugger in the street, like, if she won, she would have no idea why or what she was doing along the way. She is more of a panic and hope things work out. Pray things work out. Panic, cower in a corner. Hope the police show up. Okay, so we're putting down the bottom pieces and we're making just the regular clover design at this point. Yep, whole inside is flat. Yeah. Jeez. What was up with that momentum? Whoa, wait a minute. This is not the standard clover. Yeah, this is not the standard clover. Okay, I need to make 8 of the... Really, a gap that long? It sure is. Okay, it's a little weird looking clover, but it gets the job done. So next layer is exactly the same, except entirely checkerboard. Same thing, just checkerboard. Thank you. did have enough. And then that's that. Showed up, Aseo. How you doing, Aseo? Okay, I think that's just about it for that layer, and that means we only have one layer left. Yep, those are both indeed that. Yep. Sure are. Yeah, I just gotta put on a top layer. So we're running the top bits around the outside edge. And then the flat top's just inside. I'm gonna need 8. Wait, I just made 8 of them. Did I already have some? I did. Don't know why. Okay, then we got you guys. Okay, so it's open on that side, but it is closed everywhere else. So that's that, and we have the flat tops. I think that'll do it. Mm-hmm. Alright, so we have our hard edge over here. We've built out that far over here. So just doing the top of this hall is going to be our next goal, I suppose. Looks good from the outside. I'm gonna put some stairs down here. They're not on the map, or no, they're not on the original. But let's be honest, this whole wall barely exists in the original. This one seemed to continue on for at least a couple steps. So I'm just gonna leave that as it is and not put any on the top. Otherwise, I think we're looking good. So our next goal is figuring out what the heck is going on over here. Should the top be connected? I'm not sure what you mean. Yeah, it is about egg time. Mean like across the top up here? Like from there to there? Let's go see what the experts say. The experts say no. Yep, same deal here. That's just open. Oh, one thing I didn't do. There we go. Almost forgot about that one. Alright, make sure everything looks okay from up here. Looking nice, we got this over here. Got our chapel. Wall over here is looking good. So we have one more wall here to make. Yeah, one more wall here to make, and that'll close off our little... pond opening. I don't know what you call that. And then we just have our big old courtyard areas. Oh, this one's so tiny by comparison. I had thought up a few ways to spruce up the interior of this, but I'm realizing even the exterior needs some work. Like, look how fantastic all the exteriors of everything else is. There's just always something going on. And I wish I was actually some kind of designer, because I can never think of what I want to do with this. Like, I can never think of something interesting and creative to do. So I make a big castle and it's super plain. Because, like, what do you do to fancy it up? I could put a top on it, kind of like this. That'd help. It's still kind of big and flat, though. Okay, worry about that another time. For now, the plan is gonna be, next time, we figure out what we're doing with this. I feel like this is actually going to be kind of a headache, and I'm hoping it doesn't take up too much time. But I feel like it'll take up more time than I want it to. So I'm going to We're going to do this final haul. And then we're going to fill the wood ocean. I'm going to bring the exterior wall up as high as it needs to be. I'm going to figure out where I need the bottom to be, and we're going to fill it with wood. We're probably going to have maybe two stages of that. Or at the very least, maybe it won't be as easy as I would hope. Because we need to fill it with wood. But there's like a little inset, almost. So we're gonna have to like figure out where that is. Fill up to that, build the walls around it, and then fill up an even higher layer with wood. Well, that'll be our adventure for next time. Wrong button. So yeah, one more wall to deal with. I suppose I could go get the maybe go get the blueprint right now. Oh, chapel inside view. Yeah, sure. So you got this big symbol on the floor. We got the pillars going all the way up. Just this tiny little area up here. Okay, what can I destroy? A lot of this I'm just gonna make again next time, so I'm not too worried about it. I'll keep the staples around. Always need pretty much all of these. Not gonna be using these right away. Wooden regular blocks, though. Probably gonna use a ton of them. Anything else, I'll just make as I need it. That way my inventory is not clogged up. We can get rid of these. Yeah, we've got the tunnel in the back, too, we gotta worry about. That should be pretty easy. Just plow our way right through. ¶¶ Okay, we got us a buggy. Let's go take a look at this wall. I have no idea what I'm doing with. Sure is a whole lot of information to go with, to go by. Crap! Let's just go up here. Grab a spot like here. Yeah, that'll be sure to grab it all. And then over here, we'll just kind of do our best, I guess. Okay, didn't want to put that down there, but I'll take it. Yep, a lot of information to go by here. I mean, we almost have one half intact. Okay, didn't I put another weird block somewhere? I put it up top. Okay, so this is a double step up here. So, staircase to what appears to be flat. Then there's another step up. No indication of a staircase for it. And this goes to that little outcropping thing here, which we've seen this kind of thing before. And then it looks like it steps back down? Which, I mean, that makes sense. Design-wise. But that side is going to be 2 blocks too high. How do you get up there? And it is flat tops, it's not like these, which have the wood sitting on top of them. Because there's nothing underneath the wood. There never was. Certainly not a bunch of flat tops. Unless the flat tops is just supposed to be the bottom, and there's supposed to be a layer of checkerboard on top of that? Which I would kind of believe. It seems awkward that the checkerboard here seems very specifically over these 5. If it was supposed to cover everything, like this is a harsh flat cutoff if it was supposed to cover everything and not just this 5, and it does the same over here. Even amongst the rubble, that's a harsh cutoff. Yeah, maybe the grass was steps once. Yeah, this is why I didn't want to start with this wall. Because I feel like we're just going to have to put the pieces together and see what we end up with and go from there. Well, we have our blueprint. You know, thinking about it, I don't know. I said Vivian, like, wouldn't fight and would just be, like, huddled in a corner. And I'm torn between would she do that or would she act like... Would she act like an upset mom, almost? And just kind of... In a huff, stomp her way over to the burglar or whatever, the mugger or whatever, and say, now you cut that out, and then just like friggin' take the gun. I'm torn. I still hold she has no idea how to fight. She is not a combatant. But I could see her, like, catching them off guard and them just going, what? As she then friggin' grabs the gun with a bit more force than they were probably expecting. Like a mom scolding a misbehaving child. Not like punishing them. Not yelling at them, not spanking them, none of that stuff. But like just scolding a misbehaving child. I'm torn if she's reasonably... I'm torn at how impregnable she is. I am unsure if you could actively shoot her and the bullet would cause damage or not. And, like, that would be her opinion. That would be her belief getting into that situation. Is this guy is misbehaving. It would probably depend on the size of the gun. Oh, of course. I'm sure you get a friggin' high-power sniper rifle and it could tear through her one way or the other. But just like a regular handgun, like, how defensive do I want her to be? Do I want it to be that kind of like, oh no, she's actually pretty hard? Pretty difficult to damage? And, like, an average person would not be able to harm her? Or... would I want her to be a little bit more like actual machinery, which, honest to goodness, is surprisingly fragile? And you shoot her in the arm, and it just kind of tears through it and disables her arm. Anyway, it's late. We got a heck done today, though. We got the chapel done, we got this tower done, and we got this bridge done. That is more than I was expecting. So next time, we're gonna work on this. Who knows how that's gonna turn out. And probably gonna take a look at the wood ocean that we're gonna have to expand. Okay. I need light. So I'm gonna go ahead and head out. Later, everybody. Thanks for hanging out. Been good fun. Got a lot done. Tomorrow for Friday stream, I think I'm just gonna go back and play more Cat Quest. We just got some super powerful armor, and I kind of want to beat some guys up. So, yeah. Later, everybody.